more of that tank focused play, which we weren't really expecting.
You know, and the Valiant game is close, but we also saw how good the Valiant is because they played NYXL really close here today. So I think this is a very tough match for the Outlaws. I'm excited to see this beginning lineup, though, with the more damage dealers and see how they utilize it.
Here's your map set, ladies and gentlemen, presented by Toyota. It all starts on the map of Busan. You know, we obviously see a lot more Boink now in this Houston Outlaw squad. He only played about 33% or like a third of the matches for the Outlaws last season. And he and Bunny only played together once.
Which is pretty much his entire playtime is stage two. If you think back to last year, you know, Mercy meta, really a ton of Mercy in the support role. In stage one, three, and four, the only stage we saw a ton of Lucio last year was in stage two. That's where Boink got all of his run. Otherwise, they were pretty much playing Bonnie a lot of the time. So it's interesting how they work Boink into being a mainstay of this roster, at least here at the beginning of the season.
And I guess he was a player that, you know, spent a decent amount of time on the bench, but always was in the mix and definitely came in for those maps when they really required the Lucio to make a difference. So now, ladies and gentlemen, let's get some energy up in here. It's Hungry Spark take on the Houston Outlaws. It all kicks off here on Busan.
And when you see this lineup for the Outlaws, you know, the players on the stage, this is what you expect. So, you know, Hangzhou Spark, they come out, they're going to play, you know, this is kind of like the old school dive, so to speak. You know, a little variation in terms of supports, right? You have Moira in here.
So it's like they're expecting as well no D.Va on the opposite side.
A great comp to go after a Hammond or a Wrecking Ball, right? Mooma playing the Wrecking Ball for the Houston Outlaws. You can get hacks, you can burst them down with the Tracer.
Linkson out has a pretty interesting angle here off towards the side. No one's really paying attention to him currently. And that's it, he needs to find the opener, and he does. IDK's down. However, Hangzhou take the point to start with. Houston still need to respond, and they still need to keep leveraging this Widowmaker presence off to the side of the map and turn that into further eliminations.
Ah, really nice bio grenade there from Rockus. Connects with both tanks. No Smite and Rhea. They're going to be able to pick up a kill on a No Smite. Rhea gets D-Mac. He's quickly taken out after, but really nice play there from Rockus.
How much does that gut them, Matt, losing IDK so early on there?
Oh, I mean, it's huge, right? I mean, you lose the ability to disengage from any fights or engage with the speed boost that Lucio provides. Don't lose a ton of healing, though. I know the Moira coming in here for Hangzhou provides a ton of healing.
Biotic Orb doing a lot of burst healing. Well, they're not great at following up your dive tanks with, I suppose, unless you want to, you know, be fading forward with that Moira and potentially taking away your own escape mechanic. Oh, Dante spots out Bazzi here as well. Wrinkle already used. Dante happened to trade some shots there, but Jake sat in the corner. Oh, he's been compromised. Bazzi chases him down, but it's a trade. Both Sombras are missing. And now Dante gets the Nano Boost. Okay, I think I've seen everything now. Pulse Bomb dropped in there, eaten straight up by Rio. He'll have that one for dinner. Sustenance. Zoli's after on that D.Va roll. But the Outlaws still maintain control of the point, matter 46%.
And I wonder how either of these teams, I think actually that the Outlaws have a better opportunity to use this EMP. There's going to be the EMP that comes out. Mooma from the Outlaws, it's huge. It connects with five.
Yeah, that's nasty. Mooma gets two. One with the minefield as Bebe just walks into one. No saving Private Ryan here. And now Mooma again will be able to displace Boop and bop everyone off the point. Rhea will go for the self-destruct, probably just for a remake. It seems interesting that they want to commit so much to this fight. Hangzhou, they don't control the point.
This is a
the
viable strategy.
Just gaining percentage.
Yeah, as you see Mooma just swinging around here on the point as the Wrecking Ball does a ton of damage in this position. You see, oh, as IDK does get taken out there by Linkser as Boink uses the sound barrier to keep everybody up there for Houston.
So, oh, this is a stagger. This is, it's a form of a stagger. The sound barrier, very timely there from Boink, keeps Linkser in the fight, prevents Hangzhou from getting even one pick off. And now at 95%, it is do or die for the Spark. Rhea straight to the point, but immediately D-mech'd was Dante taking care of that one. And now he gets nano boosted here. The targets for nano booster, I don't know if you've been curious thus far, but the D.Va seems far more reasonable. The extra durability going a long way as Dante takes the fight to No Smite, but he gets that Primal Rage. Dante decides he's better off elsewhere, but No Smite wants to be nowhere else other than right up in Raucus's grill. The Ana is down. No Smite getting the Sound Barrier keeps him alive a little bit longer, but his Bath Health is a little low. In overtime, Hangzhou with the numbers on the point here. IDK falling to Linkser though, and the Widowmaker's still a threat. He's still looking for those targets, and Godspeed drops. Linkser in a great position now to get free damage unopposed. For some reason, Bazzi hasn't opted to make a beeline for him, instead dealing with Boink. Outlaws still have the numbers to keep this one going. Nosebite gets taken down. Movement drops on Elixir. Finds Rhea from the periphery, and the Outlaws
finishing style. So much fighting from Hangzhou Spark, but again, the ability to not only take the point, but to maintain control of it for them seemed to be a little bit harder to generate. We've got another round coming right up, ladies and gentlemen. Houston starting this one strong. Shortage of criticism leveled at the Houston Outlaws over the last week or so.
A lot of doubts about whether they could play the sufficient number of compositions to be competitive, but Matt, their damage dealer-centric setup seems to be effective.
And I think they just get a lot more value with their EMPs as opposed to Hangzhou. Godspeed gets taken out right away there by Linkser. But no, Jake, when he gets that EMP, everybody on Hangzhou kind of has to play together. When Godspeed gets his, the Houston Outlaws composition, you can spread out a lot. A lot of different players and heroes can play on their own with the heroes that they're running, and you can't get a ton of value with the EMP.
The Moira necessitates playing together. You cannot benefit from that area of effect healing if you're not in the same area of effect. So the Outlaws will move to the point first. It remains to be seen whether Godspeed was invisible or revealed when Linkser picked him up, but he's down. That's a second now for the Crazy Finn. Looking for one more, but Dante's doing the work on the ground here, slapping Bebe around.
They haven't really put any pressure on Linkser at all. Every time we've been on board with Linkser, he's like kind of an afterthought. It seems like they just dive the point, and they're just like letting him just hit these shots at range. Linkser's just too good of a Widowmaker to just leave unattended.
So who's getting the attention instead of Linkser then? Where are Hangzhou focusing?
It seems like they just keep getting on the point situations, and they're trying to take Mooma out. But Mooma's doing a fantastic job on Wrecking Ball, just moving around. A lot of times we see Wrecking Ball gets hacked in these situations. We haven't seen Mooma really get hacked, to get taken out early.
Good example of a team who gets a lot of value out of Wrecking Ball is also the Chengdu Hunters. Amon, very hard to kill. And we know that Mooma's been grinding a lot of Wrecking Ball on his stream, if you watch that, which I recommend. It's fantastic. Pulse Bomb for Dante. Rhea, obviously looking to eat that again, or probably not even going to try to. Dante just needs to be careful. No Smite runs him down. Now the Outlaws are down to five players. Mooma obviously got himself a bit of shielding on that high ground and is forced to back away. Bazzy wants to drop a Pulse Bomb in here, potentially does not get the stick. And Boink finds no Smite. Bazzy needs to make the difference now very quickly. Coalescence forcing the Outlaws back inside this small aperture. Jake trying to dance on the hacked health pack stays alive for a little while until Bebe finishes him off. Now the Outlaws struggling for players. They got only about three left. Mooma is staying rooted onto the point, and Bebe's down. This is the turnaround.
Hangzhou doesn't even take the point here. Godspeed's still alive, just trying to be a nuisance getting these hacks off. It started well for Hangzhou when they got the hack onto Dante and you were able to take out the Tracer. They just get nothing after that. They're going to try and get a big EMP on both supports here. You won't have any support ults if you're Houston.
Rorka's going to get microwaved here. Exactly who they had to hit. Hangzhou didn't really suffer too much from the EMP laid down by Jake. Didn't hamper their ability too much, but Mooma, that's a quick double. That's what the Houston Outlaws are looking to do. Stay in control. IDK cut down by Jake. Good peel. Even if Linkser fell, the Outlaws were still able to get something for it. At least a straight trade. Mooma just wants to maintain presence right now. He can't really chase Buzzy down. Whereas Jake could be pressured. Transcendence now. Raucus was going to get pulse bombed otherwise. The Outlaws digging into their pockets now to finish this one off here. Godspeed goes down to Jake, and Jake finds yet another one. A lot of work coming out from the DPSs on the Houston Outlaws side. And No Smite couldn't do a darn thing about that. He was hacked. And then chopped up. There it is. Houston Outlaws, cool, calm, and collected. A much better performance from them than what we've seen prior. Very quickly chalking up the first map in this series, showing us, Matt, that they have the ability to silence the doubters and play these damage dealer-centric comps. Let's see if they can finish the series. We'll be back right after these messages.
The Overwatch League is powered by Intel. Game, record, stream without compromise on Intel Core i7. And by Omen by 8.